morning. You are listening to Table for Two with Naomi Nachman on the Nachum Segal Network. Good morning, everyone. I'm so happy to be here in the beautiful summer doing our slew of summer shows, and I can't wait to introduce you to today's amazing guest. Let's get that intro on. I'm Naomi Nachman. I'm about all the food all the time. I love shopping for food. I love cooking food. I love eating food. I love eating at restaurants. Anything food related. I'm a kosher personal chef. My business is called the Aussie Gourmet. I cater for people for Shabbos, for Yontov, small parties. Anytime you don't feel like cooking, you can give me a call. I also wrote some cookbooks. I run kosher chop competitions. And I hope you'll tune in every week and hear about my cooking adventures, my kosher food traveling, and sharing of great food ideas and recipes, and from my amazing guests. I want to hear about your experiences too, so email me at Naomi@NachumSegal, and you can follow along my adventures on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, I don't know, wherever you can find me, I'll try to be there. Make this a conversation, so if you share, if you eat anything, go anywhere, let me know, I want to hear all about it. Today we have a great lineup. I personally am good friends with every single person on this show. It's every week it's like that. I love making friends in the industry, and they become friends in my real life. And my first guest is someone who is exactly that. My friend Chayasuri Leitner and I met, I don't even know how many years ago. We were at a restaurant together for a restaurant tasting in Brooklyn called Wolf and Lamb. And I feel like that was the first time we met Chayasuri, right?
Yes, I think it was.
And we became very good friends. I've gone to her for Shabbos. I keep trying to convince her to come to me for Shabbos, but she lives in Lakewood, and she goes, I love it here. Why don't you keep coming to me? So I keep going to her. She has gorgeous children. She has a great family, and she has an incredible business, and she hasn't been on the show in a while. When we did the shows in Manhattan, she used to come down to the studio, but now we're going to do it over the phone. So I'd like to welcome Chayasuri Leitner from Spice and Zest. Welcome.
Hi, Naomi. Thank you for having me.
My pleasure. It was so nice to see you. Chayasuri and I got together last week. We went for lunch at Fish Grill in Lakewood. See, I do go to Lakewood.
Yes, you do.
It was so fun. I love that place.
Yes, it was so nice to see you, Naomi. Yeah, and I got to share some really great, delicious bread fresh out of the oven.
I know. What I did was, so let me just catch everyone up. You and I was in Lakewood last week. My daughter, who just got married, was going to pick up a shaytel. So we're like, let's make a road trip out of it. And I said, I texted Chayasuri. I said, let's get together, bring the kids, and we'll go to Fish Grill. She's like, I'm going to bring you something delicious. I'm like, oh, I hope it's the bread. And she bought me her delicious bread. I actually saved it. I wrapped it like this because you can make your own sourdough and wrap it. See, she gave me this, and I wrapped it tight in saran wrap, and I put it in the freezer. Here's one that I unwrapped so you could all see how beautiful her dough is, her bread is. And she has a business called Spice and Zest on Instagram. And we said, why don't we just have you on the show again? But I did make her come.
Naomi, how did that bread manage to get home with you? It probably smelled so good.
It was amazing. Peer
into it and I picked up the whole thing.
I picked up Tzvi on the way home, and he's like, what's that smell? He goes, have you been to it with Chayasuri? And I'm like, how did you know? Because he doesn't watch the Instagram, you know. He's like, the car had her fresh bread in it. So we met up. It was a pouring rainy day. It was insane. It took us 3 hours to get home to Queens.
Wow.
Not even all the way home. I'm just
saying. At least you had some good fresh bread in the car.
Right, in case we had to, like, really stop. we had the bread, right. But we made it all the way home, thank God. Well, we actually went to Mama's Kitchen in Queens for dinner. That place is insane. Guys, you've got to check out.
I've always wanted.
Chayasuri, I know we're diverting from the bread for a second, but can I just tell you something? You've got to go there. Everyone has got to go there. Mama's Kitchen is located. They have one in Brooklyn and one in Queens on Main Street. It was insane. We actually ordered the whole menu. It was amazing.
Wow. Their food looks insane.
You would go crazy, crazy over their food. I can't wait to go back there. I'm like dreaming about it. Okay, so now let's talk about you. It's all about you right now. Tell us about the beginning, if we have some new listeners. How did you start making sourdough bread? Well, you know, so she's been doing it for more than 10 years. Before it was a trend, she was doing it.
Yeah, my starter is actually 12 years old now. Super, super strong starter. I have been baking every single week, and then it became daily for years now. I mastered it, you know, like in the days when I started, there was no research on sourdough. Like every time I Googled sourdough bread, or why is my bread not working out, or is it like everything I needed, I figured everything out on my own because there was really no resources yet at that time. People were not aware of sourdough, of the health benefits, and why they would be eating sourdough over commercial bread, until I would say the last 3 years, when COVID hit and a lot of people were home, that's when people really got into it. And then the industry exploded, and now there are so much resources out there, which makes me so happy because it's so accessible to anyone who wants to bake a healthier bread for their family, for themselves.
Why is it healthier? Why did this become like the bread to eat? Still pecks on the
sourdough is fermented. We do not use commercial yeast when we bake with sourdough.
Explain what that means.
So, which means that you use a sourdough starter, wild yeast. You take flour and water, you mix it, and every day you're going to be feeding it, which means you're going to be adding more flour and water. And with time, it's going to become active because all the good bacteria from the ear, from all around, is going to ferment that flour and water and make that into the yeast that you're going to need to use for your bread. And when you use a sourdough starter in your bread instead of commercial yeast, the one that you know from the grocery store, the one that you know, we all grew up with, you could get it in a cake or you could get it in dry yeast. But when you use a sourdough starter instead, then it's going to, the sourdough starter is going to ferment your whole dough, and it's going to break down the gluten. So by the time you bake the bread and you eat it, your body can digest your bread much better. That's why a lot of people who are gluten intolerant can handle sourdough over commercial, because their body is not working on digesting all that gluten and flour. The starter has done it for them already.
Can we just explain? Last week I had on the show Danny Saltzman from DS Tame and Whiskey, and a lot of that is fermented also, right? That's how he becomes alcoholic.
Yeah.
And you're talking about fermented. I feel like that's a bit of a buzzword right now and trending in the food and alcohol world. Okay, so Chai, tell me exactly what fermentation is.
So fermented food is when it breaks down all the molecules and it starts giving you all the food has all the good bacteria in it when you eat it, like acidophilus would be
an example
for anyone who doesn't. Right. It's probiotics. It's more like acidophilus is probiotics. Whoever doesn't understand what probiotics is, think of acidophilus. The body can digest it and absorb all the good bacteria that you need, all the good nutrients, and it's just much easier to digest and to, like, it's just way much better. It's way better for your body when you eat that versus anything that, you know, food that is not fermented. And a lot of people think that they are allergic to certain foods where really it's hard for their body to digest it. And once it's fermented, it's easier for them to eat it.
Okay. Like, let's just bring it back to yogurt, right? When you take antibiotics, it kills all the bacteria, but it kills the good and the bad bacteria. And you want the good bacteria back in, so you eat yogurt.
Right. And yogurt also, like, there are a lot of people who are lactose intolerant and they can't have milk, but they can have the yogurt, which is essentially milk, which has been fermented.
Right.
In order to make yogurt, all you do is add a starter, just like a bread starter. You have a starter for yogurt, which can be old yogurt or any good bacteria. You'll just put it into milk and you let it sit for a day, and then you got yourself some yogurt.
Right. Right. Okay. So you, so now that, so people have seen this, let's call it health benefits to eating sourdough and sourdough bread and now sourdough pizzas people are making.
Yeah, well, you can make sourdough anything. I mean, I've been making sourdough babka and cinnamon buns and burger buns and pizza and pita and anything that could be made with dough was made with sourdough. I've been making this for years. There was a while back, I remember, I would say probably like 7 years ago because my oldest was a little kid. And I remember my neighbors used to beg me to make more, like to sell the sourdough babka. But,
I would totally try that.
So instead, I'm teaching people how to do it. I'm teaching people how to bake their own sourdough bread, empowering people, how simple it is.
I love that.
Once you understand what you're doing, it's just so simple. And it's really not time consuming, this misconception that people have that sourdough takes, because
it is a little. I mean, I used to make it a lot.
So sourdough really, the bread, the dough needs to ferment for a while. You can ferment it for anywhere, like fermenting means you can let it rise for anywhere from 4 to 24 hours. That's why people think it's time consuming. But essentially when you're doing, like the actual work, the physical work that you're doing is just a few minutes here and there. It's
right.
Not,
you know, you're right.
You're not busy with it all the time. It's just sitting in your fridge for 24 hours before it's ready to bake.
So I learned how to make my sourdough. I mean, I did a little bit of like partial learning where you would take like a yeast and then you would ferment that and then you'd put it in your dough. I did that like 20 years ago. But I learned real sourdough technique from Chaisari. I want to say, remember that day with Dini Klein? Was Honey Applebaum there?
Yeah.
It was for sure.
It was Melinda and it was Miriam Pascal.
Pascal, yes.
Yes.
Or went to Dini when Dini, now known as Prep and Rally, lived in New York. Now she's in, I saw her last week in LA. We all went to Dini's house in New York and Chaisari was kind enough. It was the beginning of the friendship really developing, fermenting. and she taught us and I literally fed the starter for about 6-7 years before my starter, which I kept in a mason jar, fell out of the fridge and smashed on the floor. And I said, that was...
Wow.
Remember that?
I can't believe it's been so long ago.
Yeah,
it was... How was it?
It was July 4th, 2019. I even know the date.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, because it was July 4th weekend. And I was rushing to get something out of the fridge to go upstate for a barbecue. And I knocked the thing on the floor. And that was the end of that. And I said, it's Hashem wave saying, Naomi, you're eating too much bread. Even though it's healthy for my gut, it's still caloric. So I haven't made it. Now I just buy it. I get it from Chaisari. Locally, Malki Hirsch, Kiss the Kosher Cook, she makes it. So I buy it from her. Homegrown Kosher sells it. She actually sells hers in Evergreen.
In Muncie.
In Muncie. You sell yours in... You're still baking though, right? Like people still order from you.
Yeah.
Sometimes, yes. But now Chaisari's made this whole new course. Tell us about your course that you're doing.
So I have an online sourdough course. It's not new. This is going to be my third year.
Wow.
And yes, I launched 3 years ago in the summer, right before the summer, which was amazing because so many people love to learn in the summer. People find that they have more time in the summer. It's more leisure. So they like to bake. And I also... It's a good time to start because it's nice and warm and the starter grows much nicer in the warmth. So it's like a good head start. So it was super, super successful, the first launch. And so many people signed up and started baking right away, which made me so happy. It gave me so much nachas. And just watching it grow and seeing how simple, how people just see how simple it is and they could bake their sourdough bread. Is just amazing to see. It's amazing to see how just simplifying the whole process gives people the
empowerment. I love it. Because you
the word. Gives people the empowerment to be able to just do it.
You know, besides the word empowerment, the word amazement. Whenever I used to make sourdough and it's literally flour, water, and salt.
Yeah.
And you would watch this thing grow from this slush, right? Looks slushy, watery dough, clay concoction. Within a few hours, right, or overnight next morning, you would have, like, you saw the power of Hashem, how Hashem makes bacteria that we can just make bread. And I was always amazed how this starter turned into bread.
Yes, and I remember the first time, like when I launched the course, a few weeks later, I got an email from someone, and this is why I was looking for the word empowerment. She was telling me, she's like, thank you for empowering me to understand how simple it was. Like, those were the words that she sent, and I'm like, oh, yeah. For me, I've been doing it for so many years, I didn't even realize that people felt so overwhelmed by it.
Right.
But once you understand the process and how it works, it's so simple.
Oh, fantastic. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Okay, amazing. Hold on. Yeah. Sorry, I'm just getting out. We just had an emergency situation go on from our next guest. I'm like, okay, they had to let me know something because we want to keep the shows smooth and running, with no breaks in between when we are recording in our Long Island studio in Woodmere. okay, so how can people find out more about you?
They can find me on Instagram at Spice and Zest or on my site, spiceandzest.com. I have all the information about my online course. And you can now get a kit that comes along with the course, which you get everything you need to start baking sourdough right away. One-stop shop, you'll get your basket and the flour and the starter. Dry starter flakes, which is super strong because it's my own starter, which is an old starter, strong starter, and everything you need to start baking sourdough.
Fantastic. I think that it's inspirational. It's empowering. Chaisari is a wonderful human being. She's a great teacher. She's patient. I personally learned from her. I am vouching her system works, and she's just so smart and knowledgeable.
Thank you. And there's just one thing that a lot of people always ask me, that they feel like an online course, they might not get everything out of it. Well, I just want to say that I have been teaching for 5 years before I started my online course. And I have seen students from both be very successful. But something about the online course, you get lifetime access and you can always log in to see if you're doing something wrong, where you can, you know, improve. So that is really a big plus for the online course. And you get to see everything step by step clearly. So it's not a concern that you won't learn as well.
Amazing. Amazing. Well, I hope that everyone will go check you out. If it's not for you, it makes such a great gift, right? You've got a kid, the kids are home in the summer, all these bored teenagers are refusing to go to sleepaway camp, or the kids that are home from working in day camp.
Yes, as a matter of fact, the bread kit is set up that when you order it, you can order it as a gift for someone else.
Oh,
and when
so
they get
nice.
It, they're going to get the login to the course.
The kids who are in day camp are bored at night. Give them something to do. I may or may not be talking about, you know, people that I know.
I can tell you that every summer I have teenagers who sign up to my course, and I have seen really great results, which makes me so happy to know that even teenagers can learn so easily and make delicious bread for their family, and they feel fulfilled because they did something that everyone is enjoying.
Right, it's fantastic. It's science. It's like going back to school. It's science. This is all science. Bread baking is science. Thank you so much, Chaisari.
Thank you, Naomi.
We'll talk soon. Nice to see you last week, and I can't wait to see you again.
Same.
All right, bye. Okay, Chaisari Leitner from Spice and Zest. Check out her kit, her starter kit, and how to make sourdough bread. Okay, let's just take a moment to talk about our top picks, what is coming up. We're going to call our top picks of food to hot picks. We're going to change it because right now, we've got a hot new item that is about to hit the shelves. It's a brand new from Toscanini ketchup. Okay, a brand new. They tell me it's going to hit the shelves any moment now. They just wanted to let you know the hot new items that will be available for summer. So go check out Toscanini's ketchup. very, they told me it's like super tomato-y. So I'm like very excited because it's like my favorite vegetable. So look out for that on your shelf. So thank you very much, Toscanini, for giving us the inside track of the latest food trends. Okay, we're getting on the phone. Josh Schwartz, another good friend, lives in Florida. Always got something going on under his hat. Hello, Josh Schwartz.
Nothing's on under my hat, just a yarmulke.
Just a yarmulke. Americans say Yost, don't they? Yost Schwartz.
Yost. It's basically, Yost. It's Yosef. It just dropped the F.
Right, but I'm Australian, so you'd be Yosef. That's why I call you Yos.
Oh, you're right. No, like Yosef Wax. No,
Yos. Yeah. I'll say Yos. How are you?
I'm good. It was so nice seeing you. What a great place that was.
I know. I just had them on the show last week. On the radio show, and it was so fun to see you there at the Goldshine Farms.
Yeah, of course, I only saw your things afterwards. I realized I could have got free Slurpees.
Well, you're up there in the country, so you can go back.
Yeah. You know, the funny thing is, my son the next day, you know what he wanted to go back for?
The puppies.
The most? No, he didn't go into the puppies at all. the daughters did. My 4-year-old son, my 6-year-old. In front of the house, they had the little tractors and the bouncy things, the play area and the swings.
Yeah,
he was enthralled with. Yeah, he was like, oh, I want to go back to that, you know, that place.
Oh, that's so cute. I love it. Okay, so Yos, tell us about Kosh and Marble and Meat and how you are.
Hold on, are we recording?
Yeah, we are recording.
Okay, quick question before: when does this air?
This is actually when are everyone listening to this? Everyone is listening to this. The weekend, this is airing July 9th, like the week after.
Perfect. I wanted to know if I could talk about what I'm doing up here eventually. Okay.
Like you can summer. Talk about that. This is a very casual conversation.
I'm saying my pop-ups.
Yeah, oh, no, yes, saying, of course. You can talk about your pop-up.
I just wanted to know if it was going to be in August. I wouldn't be here anymore. But okay.
Yeah, perfect. No, this is July. They are listening to this in July.
Okay, excellent.
This is a little bit behind-the-scenes banter that goes on. We're just putting it out there, guys. Okay, so tell us what you're up to these days.
Okay, so I am up to, for about the last year, I've been working with a company called the J Commerce Group, and we've been working on basically bringing high quality gourmet kosher items. I say items because, yes, we're very meat focused and, you know, meat, poultry, fish, and stuff like that, but there's also a lot of pantry and a lot of other things that are coming down the line. So I'm not trying to be a meat company, you know, a la Grow and Behold. I'm trying, that's just, you know, meat and about, you know, where the animals are, how they're being raised and, you know, no antibiotics. I'm trying to be we're quality meat. So I am involved in some farm and animal raising, but it's mostly about sourcing. Mm-hmm. I'm using my connections over being a chef over the last 25 years and the last 10 years as a very high-end chef, which had access for private chefs, for private customers, you know.
Incredible.
And I had no budget kind of clients. And
uh-huh. I love those kind of clients.
It gave me access to, like, I always have a freezer of, you know, illegally smuggled in from Israel raw foie gras. You know,
really?
You know, that's still not legal to sell here, but I'm working on it, you know.
Oh.
That's like... Yeah, that's going to be my pinnacle when I get the... So I'm working on the foie gras from France. The can might have a better chance of
selling. I'm going to be in France. Probably while this is airing, I'm in Paris. I'm just saying.
Perfect. So, so you'll see a lot of those. Yeah, take pictures of any canned foie gras you see from me, please.
Okay, done. That'll be my assignment. I'm doing it as we speak.
So it's basically like everyone knows that, like, restaurants have better access than, you know, stores and... You know, it's also because a lot of things are done, you know, the better quality done in small batches. I can tell you from my own experience as a chef, my quality of food when I'm cooking for 6 people is a lot different than when I was doing a, you know, diet delivery service and just one kitchen was cooking for 2,000 people. You know,
wow.
it just that's how it's going to be, you know, so quality in number in smaller numbers. What else I did, you know. We just raised some geese and had it shechted last week. You know, again, I only have 23 geese. They ain't going to be cheap. It wasn't cheap to buy them or feed them or raise them, you know.
Wow. But, where can one buy them?
On kosh.com. we're getting to the point of what I'm up to.
Okay.
So I'm actually, so I started a website called kosh.com, K-O-S-H, you know, short for kosher. And it's basically a online quality gourmet, just, you know, I can't believe that's kosher items.
Wow.
You know?
Like, what's the crazy thing you've got on the site right now?
Crazy things, again, it's more unique.
Unique is crazy.
So, like, again, squab, and geese. And I have Wagyu, full-blooded, 100% American full-blooded Wagyu.
Wow.
Out of Texas. Yeah, so it's, you know, I've been selling that already. It's been on my site for years. It's selling nicely. I've been selling that to, you know, friends of mine, private chefs, for years. That
I don't even know how
you
to
know,
cook
it. I've been helping them. It's the easiest thing to cook. Like, it's just you sear it quickly and keep it raw, and it just melts in your mouth.
I happen to
personally love the Denver over the ribeye. The ribeye is so ripped. It's so fatty. You cannot, like you, not you, but me, cannot sit down and eat a whole entire, like, ribeye, you know, like I normally could. Like, I'm talking about a 2-inch ribeye, not a, you know, half-inch ribeye, a real ribeye. And then I also sell fish. I'm sourcing beautiful, like, tuna saku blocks that, like, are sushi grade, that are just come. They're easy to sear. They're easy to use with sushi. They're great for poke. They already come squared off. All you got to do is dice it, you know.
My mouth is watering.
I'm working, again, and I have things in the pipeline. I'm working on a cook program here. So I'm going to start making my own pastrami's and roast beefs. And I want to do bone broth. No one's been doing bone broth in the kosher world, and there's been a few people have tried, but being that I am, you know, have these butchers and specialty meat and processing, obviously if you're processing meat, you have a lot of bones, and bones don't allow, unfortunately, a lot of restaurants and caterers are not doing like how I was taught and grown up in the culinary world of making their own stocks and stuff like that. Like, but so we have overload of bones. I'm going to make bone broth, and I it's very healthy, and people like it.
Yeah, people are very into that.
Very into that. I actually think we're just seeing the beginning of that trend.
Really?
I think in a year's time, I won't be the only bone broth on the market in the kosher world. I think.
What does one do with bone broth? Just put it in the chicken soup? What do you do with bone broth?
No, I'm talking, first of all, I'm talking about beef bone broth right now.
Yeah, I understand. What do you do with that?
Yeah.
Just put in the chicken soup?
You can put it in your chicken soup to fortify your chicken soup, but you can also literally drink it as soup, or you can put vegetables in it and make it, use it as your soup base. It's like, you know, the shelf-stable soups like that? This is like that. It's just not shelf-stable. It has way more protein than a chicken soup. It has a lot of all those vitamins. It's more of a health play. And like I said, for me, it's about, you know, bringing, you know, quality, something that I feel the market is asking for that no one's doing.
Where did you get your training from? Your length and depth and breadth of knowledge is amazing. I don't know if I've met any other Frum chef that has your vast knowledge.
So I went to culinary school with a non-kosher culinary school with not eating or anything with a specific... the specific goal in mind was, even if I don't end up being a chef, I'm going to gain this knowledge. So I really went to culinary school for the knowledge of cooking more than I happened to love it. I knew I wanted to be a chef. But I was like, let's say something happens where, you know, I married the family, need to help out a business. You know, I was a kid. I was like, at least I went to culinary school, I'll be happy. And that's where I went. So, right. And that knowledge hasn't stopped, obviously. There's just so much, there's too much knowledge out there. I can't even grab it all with the internet and stuff like that.
We're always learning in whatever industry.
Yeah, I kind of feel, I've noticed something else about myself because I'm so engraved in this industry since I'm 14 years old, basically. I see trends coming, and you know, have my ear to the ground on that. And unfortunately, or fortunately, it depends on, like, I had businesses that I've done in the past that I was ahead of my time, a lot ahead of my time, and other, you know, that now it was like, you know, I was part of a food tech company before there was the term food tech, you know.
Right.
Unfortunately, when I couldn't raise a dollar based on it. And then, you know, and then after we sold it, it was like, I saw companies that I helped start that were raising $20 million on a nothing and were gone in a year. Like,
right.
You know, like it just, whatever. It was a crazy, crazy food tech time out there. And then, and again, my passion's always been kosher. I've always tried to stick to the kosher market because, again, I have an item that is a simple item. I love it. It's my favorite jams in the world for two reasons. Not that the Bon Marie is not a good jam. It's a great jam. I also feel, again, it's just overplayed. It's in every kosher, non-kosher store across the world, you know?
What is it?
I like, it's the French jam, Bon Marie, you know.
Oh, like, what's it called?
Bon Marie. I'm definitely butchering it, but
I've got the worst.
Don't tell the people in Paris.
I know, right? This is airing, I'm in Paris.
So long story short, it's called Blake Hill, the company that I chose to curate. I'm brought to my site, and for many reasons. But one of the reasons is even in the non-kosher world, it's not an heavy Whole Foods. It's not, you know,
right,
it's not
right.
Overplayed. It's just a unique jam. They do a lot of savory stuff. They have roasted garlic. They have caramelized onion jam. They have a lot of stuff that to me, a lot of people want that on the burger, right? But if I'm just throwing a quick two burgers on the grill tonight for me and my wife, I'm not necessarily, I'm a chef, we don't cook that much at all, but I'm definitely not.
I know, there's nothing to eat in my house ever.
The only way I'm having onion jam is because I had an event the night before that I made it for, you know? So this is something I just want people to understand. There's good quality shortcuts that they can go ahead and, you know, and there's a whole, there's a...
Up the flavor.
There's a raspberry mostarda that literally I just rub on duck breast and, you know, and sear it. And that's my recipe.
Yum, yum. I just got black garlic paste.
In
Wisconsin. So black garlic
in Wisconsin? Yep. With Oshkosh?
Yep. Yep.
Oh, interesting. Yeah,
from that spice, the Spice House in Milwaukee has it.
I'm not. You have to send me a picture of that.
I'll send you a picture. Yos, this was amazing. Thank you so much for being on the show. So let's just talk about how the website is kosh.com.
And if you're upstate this summer, I'm doing On the Farm, which is on exit 116 off the 17. I'm doing pop-ups every Thursday from 2 to 10 p.m. I'm doing grilling. I'm going to even, you know, not just my food. I'm even going to have some Grown Behold sausages. Just so I make my own, I think those are the best. you know, then when I make my own, obviously mine will be the best. But, you know, but I'm just going to have a very cool atmosphere. We're building a grill, very cool, like Argentinian style fire pit grill. And we're going to just have a lot of fun. And so, you know, guys are driving up or people driving, you know, down just to come, you know, for dinner.
Where is it going to be located? Where's the pop-up located?
It's on the farm. It's in Pine Bush, New York. It's right off of exit 116 on the 17.
Will you post it on your Instagram?
My Instagram. It's going to be I'm doing soft launch this Thursday, and then it's going to be starting for real next week. And this can go through the summer. And
so will it be there in August? After I'm going to be up in the country.
The problem
with
August is the 9 days.
But
there's two Thursdays in the 9 days this year. So half August. No, basically.
You can do fish. Do fish.
I'm also doing it like a farmer's market. Like, it's not just about the restaurant.
Okay, it's really a whole situation.
You could come in and you can buy meats and stuff for your grilling on Sunday. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You buy steaks. You can buy Wagyu burgers, which are affordable. Everyone hears Wagyu, they think nothing's affordable, but burgers are.
Okay.
You know?
You'll send me some. Okay, I used to cook some incredible lamb that you sent me a couple of weeks ago. Thank you so much for joining us. Here, I've got my... These are for you guys. Thank you so much for joining us, and I hope to have you back on the air again. I want to cook with you on air.
Yeah, come on, when you come back from all your amazing travels, come on back to the farm.
Done. All right. Thank you, Yas. Bonjour.
All right, bye.
I don't have to say goodbye in French.
Have a safe trip.
All right, thank you. All right, hi, guys.
Hi.
We're moving right into our next guests. Welcome.
Thank you.
Okay, you've got headsets here. Okay. While Yas came in, my two guests, Julie and Malky, have arrived with something incredible. That Malky's a frequent flyer on Table for Two.
She, I've been on the way.
At least once a year you come on the show.
So.
You're probably one of the most frequented guests.
Ooh,
and Julie is a new friend, and I met her through Malky, and I'm like, I need to have you guys on the show and have you on together. Okay. Are we good? I feel like there's a lot of rustling. Are we good?
No, it's good.
Okay. Great. Thanks. Hi, both of you. Welcome.
Thanks for having us.
Our pleasure. I saw a little tagging going on yesterday as you were preparing for the show today.
Yes.
So, Malky is Kiss the Kosher Cook on Instagram. Julie is Paper and Presents.
She has...
A non-food Instagram account, but she really needs to incorporate all that into her incredible board. She's the board queen. What does that mean? Right? When you hear me words, she doesn't put you like boredom. She makes beautiful, beautiful boards. Boards are right in right now. Remember back in the day we used to call them platters?
Yes.
Well, the word platters is out. And the word boards is in.
We call them board meetings.
Board meetings. And we are going to have a board meeting right here on Table for Two. And ZK and I are very thankful when we have guests that bring us food.
You have everything you need.
Right.
Well,
here.
You have bread and
I had Chaya Suri on the show. I met up with her the other day.
She's frozen, and she
now has a new online course. I'm just sharing with the listeners. And you know that I just had on the show also Josh Schwartz. You know,
sure.
So Josh was on the show. I feel like we've all been at events with him.
Yeah.
I said for the summer season, and you did a beautiful cheese board. I'm seeing here.
Yes.
We've got the 9 days coming down fast with us, and I'm actually going to be doing a collab with Snuva Cheese.
That's amazing.
So I thought that was very exciting. So I thought, you know,
so
have you guys on the show.
Can you get the theme of this board?
I am going to say, now this is going to air a week after July 4th. We have this.
But
it is a July 4th summer patriotic. Board, because I see red, white, and blue, and I see stars.
Mm-hmm.
We have a camera that is showing everyone what is going on here. But a lot of our listeners are literally listeners listening. But we have our Nachum Segal Net YouTube channel. This is the time where I urge the listeners to become viewers because you're going to want to see this board. ZK, I'm going to ask you to take some photos of this stunning board. I'm sure you guys have got some photos of this stunning board.
Actually, we rushed over here. But I'm going to take a shot really quickly.
Okay.
If that's okay.
And ZK will also... You can do it.
He's taking a picture. It'll be fine.
You do that and you can also do this. I walk around also sometimes, you know.
Okay, great.
That's what we do here. We're going to put the board on hold for a minute.
Yeah.
Just talk to Malky, catch up with her.
Absolutely.
Catch up with Julie. Okay. Hear all about Julie and then tie the board meeting together.
Excellent.
Okay, Malky, so mazel tov.
Thank you so much.
You've gotten married since you've been on the show last.
Yeah. Busy year,
Baruch Hashem. Kids got off to camp, okay?
Oh my God, I just dropped them off. This could not have come at a better time.
I know. When I wanted
her, this is the pool.
I'm coming with you guys. I said to Malky and Julie, you know, are we on? She goes, well, I've got my kids at 10. I'm like, no, I need you for 12:30. She goes, I'm done.
Yeah.
I'm in. I'm there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So good. So the kids are off to camp.
Three kids in sleepaway.
Oh, so you just got two kids at home?
Two kids at home. It's the most vacation I'll ever have until they're out of the house for good.
But we're
years away from that.
Baruch Hashem.
And they're all in camp today and they're happy. It's just like summer is just the best.
I know. And it happens to be today that the day we are recording the show, it is a beautiful day outside.
Yes.
Sometimes when I do a slew of shows in one day, which you guys know I do, it's like when it airs, it's raining outside.
Yes.
And then we're talking about the weather. So
the last time I was here, we did it outside.
Do you remember we were? It was the first show that we did during when we went back after Corona. and it was outside because there was no vaccines yet. I want to say September of 2020.
It was hot.
It was hot, and we were like dripping. I think Alex Rappaport was here with his full garb from Must Be Up. And Danielle on the show, who was sitting on a beach in Tel Aviv over the phone. So that was things have changed. We've come a long way. Things are open. Mark, you're going to run a trip for NCSY?
I'm going TJJ Moms in a week from today.
Okay,
very
amazing.
Exciting.
It's probably like 2 days from now.
It's next.
Well, when we're airing.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. It's going to be the.
It's very confusing.
July 5th.
July 5th. And May. Oh, yes. So you're already in Israel. This is airing. How's the trip going?
It's so fun. Far, right? It's incredible.
Can I just say how it's so incredible? I just saw your Nina Wind at the store, and I'm going to meet up with you at Yom NCSY.
I'm so excited.
I'm going to be doing cookie competitions with the kids in Israel.
When I look at your schedules for the summer, I'm like, I mean, I get like a little drop of, you know, but I mean, it's going to be
a grueling schedule, but I'm very excited.
I'm sure.
And you're going to love Yom NCSY. If anyone is in Israel and they want to come to Yom NCSY, you can
join the thousands of NCSYers.
You can actually come. It's actually open to the public.
It's just incredible.
Make a donation, and Mordechai Shapiro will be.
Oh, it's going to be amazing.
Last year was a game changer. I told my husband he's got to be in Israel with me on Yom NCSY.
Oh, my God.
Everything just worked out great.
Amazing.
So very exciting. Anything foodie news that's going on in your life?
Foodie news. I don't know.
What are you up to? Cooking up a storm for the family?
It's so funny how like the last few weeks with my kids home, it was like, guys, pizza or macaroni.
Right.
I was tapped out, you know, but I think I need to like gain a little bit of, you know, just momentum now. The truth is I'm leaving in a minute, so
right.
I haven't done much, but I am doing work with Four Seasons right now, and it's been amazing. I'm so happy there. Thank God. Very nice. It's been wonderful.
And all this is from Seasons?
This is a combination. Yes. Some things are from Seasons. Some are from Target, right?
Trader Joe's.
Yeah.
Okay, so we have a mix here.
Absolutely. Yes.
Well, thank you so much for both of you for preparing a beautiful board.
Thank you so much. I hope you enjoy it.
Yeah, we're gonna talk about the board in a little bit. So, Julie, nice to meet you, on Table for Two. Have you on the show. Tell us about your business that you do. Give your other business, your non-foodie business, a shout out. Because I'm a big believer in women networking and helping each other.
Well, the funny thing is Malky's really selling houses.
Yes.
And I'm in the stationery business.
Yeah.
And somehow during COVID and I guess a mix of other events, we were just trapped at home. And we took a love to
We would just on Instagram send each other
photos
of boards.
Right.
And you live near each other.
I sold her house.
Oh, even better. So did you know each other before that?
No,
she messaged me. She's like, "Hi, stranger, I want to be my neighbor."
Yeah.
And I'm like, "Really?"
Yeah.
She's like, "I have four boys, you have four boys."
Yeah.
So the poor person.
No.
Yeah, there's like one house like in between us that they want.
They're poor box.
Yeah.
They're itching to get out.
Really?
Their kids are grown.
They're like trapped between.
And they're trapped between eight boys. And a girl.
And one little Rosie.
Little Rosie,
So, and the first week we moved actually to our neighborhood, we were like unpacking, and there was like that styrofoam that comes in like a box.
Boxes.
And her son and my son got to it and just decided, you know, we're going to like crinkle it all up and make it into like tiny, tiny, you know, the pieces that you need like a major vacuum to pick up.
Yeah,
all over the box lawn.
In July.
Like, it looked like Christmas snow all over. And we were like, no. We were like on our hands and knees, like.
Picking up the styrofoam.
Little styrofoam pieces. So it's been fun.
That's basically like our life.
The beginning of the love affair of the boys and you guys.
Yeah. And the fact that like, it's just like a really fun outlet where mothers, we have young kids. They always want to eat. That's like they're
whether young or old, so we always want to eat.
But boys, I think more than anybody, they're just.
Well, the funny thing is, what happened was you came to my house for Shabbos, and for an appetizer, I made a big like charcuterie board, not just the meat, and
charcuterie.
I pronounce that.
Remember, I'm in Paris right now.
Oh my God, you are in Paris. What are you eating right now in Paris?
Foie gras.
Ooh.
Yeah, and croissant.
And croissant.
Not together. Because I'm having a real butter one.
Yeah.
So I bring it out, and Malky's like, oh my God. And she's like looking for her phone, and I'm like, it's Shabbos. You can't take a picture. She's like, this is amazing. Let's make one during the week. So we made one. Then we did a dinner board, and my kids they devoured it. It was like something about
being... Because you eat with your eyes.
Right.
It's true. And kids about, love it. They love a board of stuff and you just take what you want.
Remind me to give you your board back.
That board's been around, no? No?
No. I mean, I've kept it here at the side.
Oh, okay.
You haven't taken it with you? It's a different...
Nah.
No, I don't know.
No, when your machatanim came, you presented a beautiful cheese board.
Yeah, I did.
I think so.
No, I did the waffle board. Yeah, I used the waffle board. Yeah, yeah. I'm thinking. I have to think now. Which machatanim? Thank God.
You just married.
Yeah.
So yeah, no. That board's for you. That was a gift.
No. No.
Do you know how many boards I have? It's embarrassing.
Oh, when Julie goes in any store that has like a wooden plank, it's.
It's a board.
It's a board. And her husband's like, do you need another one? It's like whatever, what do you like go shop for that you always just like have enough of, but you just can't.
Knives.
There you go.
Yeah, too many knives.
So Julie,
no
boards.
Such thing.
No,
boards.
Definitely not.
Yeah. Well, thanks.
So this is how, she's been loving like this for years. And then we just started
and it took it off. And people were messaging Malky, wow, this is amazing. Do more. So we did a taco board. We did a hamburger board. We did
sushi.
We did a sushi board. Different themes.
Yeah. Are you posting this anywhere in particular that people can see?
Just my page.
On your page.
Yeah.
So if I want to see all the different boards.
I also have a highlight.
A highlight.
Yeah.
Okay, a highlight on Instagram is where they can take all the favorite things from the post and stories and put it on a highlight.
Mm-hmm.
Hope that explains it for the non-Instagrammers.
Right.
Do you give classes in this? Besides for me, because I went to them.
We've done it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So any coming up that people...
We did a shul event a couple of weeks ago.
Was
it was
fun.
Really fun.
Which
in Northwood Mirror. BK.
Okay, yeah,
yeah,
sure.
I really was. And it was a sisterhood event. And it was
so fun.
Really successful. It was really fun. Yeah, they had a great time.
This is magnificent.
They have a great sisterhood. I mean, she said she put a highlight on her Instagram. She has two highlights, one boards
and one conversations with Julie, which is...
People like... Constantly.
You could just hire Julie just to like make you laugh.
People come up to her and they like compare it to like Laverne and Shirley.
Yeah.
They're like, you guys are such a good duo.
We just have
so
like
funny.
A
good back and forth.
Yeah,
that's why I needed you both on.
So I called her like 5 minutes before we were supposed to leave, and I'm like, I cut like a huge piece of my finger off
today
on a mandolin. No,
when we had the
demo.
It was for 8 o'clock. This was seven.
Yeah. So she's like, well, of course that.
Of course,
of
you
course
did.
That was going to happen.
Of course you did.
So thank God I got my stitches in and we did the demo.
That actually happened to me when I first started teaching sushi classes.
Oh my God.
I want to say more than 15 years ago.
What did you do it on?
So I was taking out the food processor and the blade fell on my finger.
No.
It wasn't packed away properly. So note to everyone, pack away the blade properly inside the machine.
Also,
don't leave it on top.
Yep. If you're Julie Holzer, never use a mandolin.
No, okay.
Just, or use the,
You said you were going to buy me gloves.
Yeah, there's a magic glove,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah, there is. Yeah. Suzanne from Kitchen Caboodle sells it.
Yes. Yes.
I've got
okay.
For Pesach.
Okay.
And the thing cut me and Dr. Marcel Scheinman.
Oh.
Save my finger.
Yeah, she tried him, but he wasn't available.
I went to someone else.
But we went to a guy from Northwood Mirror, a girl that was at the event. Her husband is a doctor, so he stitched right at their kitchen table.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic.
Yeah.
No nerve damage, right?
I don't know. Hmm. Time will tell.
No, you'll know right away. I'll check for you.
You check for me.
Actually, I did this with a razor last year for sourdough. I was... scoring bread like you see over
there.
See
how here the bread is.
And I was putting the razor back into the...
So you do that with a razor.
Right. I was putting the razor back into like the safety and it slipped. And I had to get it stitched by Meishi Weisberg.
Okay.
Because he was my son's cousin. Leaning Rebbe, so I figured...
His mother's probably listening to the show. Edie!
We love him!
My cousin.
I messaged Rivka. I was like, do you think I have to get this stitched? And she's like, it looks pretty bad. Let me send it to Meishi. So he called me. He's like, you need to get to the hospital. I was like, how about if I come to your house instead? And he's like, I guess.
Okay.
So, yeah. Shout out.
Our war wounds. Every chef has war wounds.
Oh, everybody does, yeah.
So, sure. So give us, you know, everyone's going to start making boards now because they're seeing it here on, hearing it here on Table for Two.
Yeah.
Tell us some secrets behind the board.
So Julie has there's a whole chassid, there's a whole method to doing the right kind of board.
Okay.
There are different types of elements that have to be on each board
right.
And tell them what that is.
I mean, so So the cheese is always the most fun because you have different shapes, you have different textures, you have different, you have a variety.
But that would go with any kind of, even meat. You'd right. have, you'd want different textures, different shapes, different
colors. Cut.
Yes, definitely.
Right. And then they, you know, like the general rule is put something sweet, something salty, something crunchy, something with like a little kick. But with cheese, it's just fun because you can do shapes like these. They call this the fan. That's very popular. You taught me that the honey goes best on goat cheese.
Mm. Right. With a cracker.
That was you.
Honey and caramel dolce de leche.
That was amazing.
Right.
That was so good.
So some people like...
I left that on table for two.
It's delicious.
I've got to hook you up with a cheese guy. I've got to have you guys on together.
Yes.
There'll be a show. There'll be a show.
But you can do a lot. So like even this is a rose and it's made out of cheese.
Let's hold that up and show everyone. Look at that. Look how beautiful.
Different cheeses. That's and, why it's different
But you
colors.
Could do this with different things.
You can do it with a cucumber. You can do it
if
with...
If you want to do flesh or para, you can do it instead with right. different...
And she put like some little rosemary down the side just yeah. to give this a pop of color.
Mm-hmm.
I love cheese. Is it okay? We're going to eat soon.
I mean, the key is just to fill all the spaces. Make sure, you know, it's... Even though you can do it the other way, too. There are people that like to have it spread out
right.
and not touching.
Look at the look at the fruit leather on a... Mm-hmm. Whoops. Oh, see, I pulled out some of the white candy beans.
Also, it's fun to do with the goat cheese or any type of log. You can do edible flowers. You can do dried or fresh herbs. Mm. And it just gives it a pop of color.
This right. looks amazing. Okay. And then we have fruit and we have candy.
Mm-hmm.
Right. And then you some the stars, like if you would do a meat board and you want to do olives and little like pickles, those like juicy liquidy things are better in
just
a
contained.
Small, right. So
right.
like the liquids
right.
don't. So that's really why people have the little, like, you'll see the ramekins on the board.
Like these little cutie pies are from, I think you sent me to Amazing Savings. Mm-hmm.
That's the best way to make a rose. I know the champagne glass has, like, taken off on Instagram and TikTok to do the rose.
They do it with salami. They do it with cheese.
I like those cups. I like these.
Yeah, they're very cute. They're very cute.
Yeah, some other...
Yeah, it's beautiful. There's, like, a lot of things going on here.
Mm-hmm.
Because you've got cheese and grapes and candy,
mm-hmm. right?
Fruit, honey.
Right. We did an ice cream board. The
kids'
that
was amazing.
Eyes.
That was amazing.
That's on your page.
Yeah.
The kids' eyes like popped out. They came home from school and we had this like all the flavors, cones, every topping you could imagine. It was amazing.
Yeah. And did you put them in like the little cups or the saucer? Like how'd you do it?
We put the actual like container on the ice cream. Container on the board so they saw the flavor.
Well, it must have been a big board.
It was.
I can even show it to you.
Yeah, let's have a look.
Yeah, sure.
We want to see the board, guys.
Absolutely.
Turn on those YouTube channels today.
What other fun one? We did a hot cocoa board. That was really
yeah,
fun in the winter.
I remember that one.
The kids just like it. They feel like they're part of something. So like when they came home and they saw a big taco board for dinner, they were like putting it together. The whole thing was gone. I was shocked.
Here.
Oh, guys, that's amazing. I'm swiping left. Okay, I see what you did. That must have been a really big board.
It was, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, ZK, can we just get a zoom in on that? How insane does that look?
Keep it up a second.
Okay, ZK's got the camera up close.
All right, we got it.
And then amazing. There's other ones. There's like here. There's a...
So people can see all the... amazing boards on Malky's page
yes.
through Malky's page, Kiss the Kosher Cook.
Mm-hmm.
Now, tell us a little bit, Julie, about the stationery. Like,
oh, so I rent space in Events 360 on Central Avenue. Everyone is their own vendor. So it's really like the brainchild of Michali Weinstein and Naomi Cohen. They started Events 360, and then we all rent space from them in this. And we all... basically work together in a sense, because if they need something for a party, their vendors can supply that. So there's a balloon person, there's a makeup artist, there's a florist. I'm personalized gifts and stationery. That's my section in the...
So if your kids are going off to camp, I mean,
oh my God.
Some of them have already gone off to camp.
But it's the best thing
but,
in the world.
But especially like Camp Katie girls, they're only going in August. Mm-hmm. Your daughter's going for second month. This is a really good gift to give them to... when they leave.
But you
camp.
Can even send it to them in camp.
Right.
Oh, there you go. She has these pillows right. where she has the campers right. that could sign.
Oh, the signing pillows.
Yeah.
Like in the car, Malky's like,
I want to give something to Yosef. He just went to Kaylee yesterday.
He's like, she's like, I want you, like from start to finish, like you handle it and just.
I'll give you money and you do it.
Once a week, send the kids something.
Something. Yeah.
That's a great idea. Yeah. You should do like a summer subscription.
Yeah. So I'm pretty much at the post office every day. I hang out there.
They're like, hey, Julie, what up?
But she does like teacher gifts also, anything personalized, duffels, things that, you know, any kind of gift you want to give for a baby or like anything, clothes bags. So you do clothes bags, right?
Yeah, tons of bat mitzvah gifts, bar mitzvah gifts.
Yeah.
So
wedding gifts?
I mean, what could you occasionally do? Here and there. Yeah, for sure. People will do like a personalized board or...
the personalized boards are nice.
They're nice, yeah.
Like these kind of boards.
Yeah.
Oh, I like that. But you can't chip them off to camp.
Oh, you mean like saran wrap a fun board?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, but you could personalize a board like this.
Yeah.
Like you'll say Naomi's board. And you can do that.
Absolutely. Yeah. Oh, I gotta get you one.
It's in the store. You can see it.
I'll give you a board to etch.
Okay. But I think like the whole fun around the food and the putting the boards together is like the people like they come up to me on the street. I never met them, and they're like, we just have fun like watching the two of you. You know. Talk back and forth.
Yeah. And I'm like, this is like normal.
Because Malky's so real. Like, there's no.
She's a straight shooter. That's why I love that Malky.
So we just have a good time and we are obviously.
Feeding our children very well.
Yes.
Yeah.
And yourselves.
Yeah. Because they're benefiting from it. You know what I mean? Like, they come home and they see these things. They're like, is this for us? And I'm like, yeah. I mean.
Because who else wants it? Well, this one's for Naomi.
This is for Naomi. Exactly. Enjoy it.
So fun.
Guys, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thanks for having us.
Time flies like so fun. It goes like that, right?
It was awesome.
Thank you so much for joining us, and thank you for bringing such a beautiful cheese platter, which we will eat off camera. ZK is very excited. We've got music sponsored by our friends at Kedem right up until Lich Benching. I want to wish everybody a Shabbat Shalom.